This is the Procolored A4 direct-to-film printer. In this video, we're going to show you the unboxing, setup, and first print. Let's go ahead and unbox the Procolored A4. Now you're going to see these kind of wing latches on either side. I'm going to undo the ones in the back, but right here in the front, we're going to come around. Just going to turn it counterclockwise. It's a lefty-loosey situation. There we go. Make sure those are out of the way. And we're gonna take the top off. I love it. I definitely appreciate Procolored for using these really sturdy cases. I feel like it's great. Make sure everything's nice and safe. Now, before we pull out the main box, let's go ahead and get these peripherals out of here. You gotta be careful. Actually, we're gonna grab this film first. There we go. This is gonna be our roll of A4 film. We're gonna set that to the side. Piece of styrofoam. This is just keeping everything together. And then here we have our bag of accessories. Now, some of these are going to be used immediately, and some of these are going to be spare parts, which is great. I appreciate that they send spare. So let's just move this to the side as well. Right here in the bottom, we'll see if we could access this first, or we might have to come back to it. Yeah, my hands are too fat. We're going to come back to that. Let's go ahead and get this box out. And here is our printer. You wanna be very careful with this, so I'm going to scoop my crate over, set down my printer, and now I could pull the last part out of the crate. And just so you guys know what's inside here, more accessories. We're gonna dive into this in a little bit, but as you can tell, got some syringes here. We have our software, do not lose that, very important. And then, of course, we have part of the assembly for our roll feeder and other important parts. So we're gonna don't need this crate anymore. Well, I should say we don't need this crate for setup anymore. You do want to keep it just in case you need to send your machine back for servicing or anything like that. It's very important that you keep that crate. I'm gonna go ahead and open this box now. I'm excited. I love New Gear Day. And here at Heat Press Nation, I feel like it's very frequently New Gear Day. There we go. Oh, this is great. This is beautiful. Now, right here, we have the user manual. This is really nice. Has everything we need in there printed. So there is a video, of course, while you're watching the video right now, but let's just say you lost internet connection, you couldn't finish this video. Don't worry, you got the manual. And I'm gonna turn this around to face you guys because who says things can't be cute, can't be good looking? We have our cute little panda right here, and we're gonna go ahead and carefully remove the printer from the box. You're gonna wanna make sure you can get a nice grab point. Now, if for some reason you're having a little bit of trouble gripping it, I wouldn't destroy this box. Just try your best. There we go. Gonna carefully remove that. There's nothing else in this box that's important. We're gonna go ahead and move that to the side. And don't be afraid to get help. If you feel like you need a second person to help work it out of the box, go ahead and get a second person. You don't need to do it alone. All right, let's go ahead and get this unwrapped. Of course, very carefully. I'm gonna try to avoid using my knife here just because I don't wanna scratch it. It's beautiful, it's gorgeous, and I don't wanna mess it up. What I will do is I'll get some scissors and carefully just cut in some strategic places. And I'm working really hard to avoid scratching or gouging my brand new printer. Wow. This thing looks great. I love the panda. It feels like it's already my friend. And I know it's going to be your friend because it's going to be making you a lot of money. So, yeah. All right, now that we've unboxed it, you want to go all the way around and give it a good look. Just make sure that everything is exactly how it's supposed to be and that nothing was damaged in shipping. Everything looks great to me here. I mean, this thing is packaged really well. I honestly do not expect anybody to have any issues. I mean, unless FedEx just, you know, threw it out of the plane or something. Now, as you reach inside here, there is a printer test page. Now, at the factory, Procolored tests every single printer before it heads out the door, and they include a printer test page to show that all nozzles have been firing. So I'm gonna put that right there. It's a little bit hard to see the yellow, and you're definitely not going to see the white. But as you can see all colors there showing, so you know this thing's firing properly, looking great. So thank you, Procolored, for that. Just another assurance that everything's gonna be great. Okay, so now we're gonna visually inspect the inside. We're gonna lift this up. And one thing that's cool about this lid is it has like a lock on it. If you wanna close it back, you're just gonna lift that latch up, free it from that lock. So that's pretty cool. There we go, it's gonna hold itself open. And now we're gonna look inside again. Just make sure that there's no visible damage, no loose, shaky parts or anything like that. We don't expect that to be the case, but again, when you're getting something that's been shipped to you, you just wanna make sure everything is good before you actually start pouring inks and getting started. Let's get this thing ready for our machine self-test. Now, if you look inside here, and there is a notice, it says, the new customer must remove the ink car fixing plate before inserting the power cord. So what that is, there is a little yellow bracket right here, and that holds the printer assembly in place while it's being shipped. So we're just gonna get our Phillips head screwdriver. And we're going to remove this bracket. Try your best to not lose this bracket, because if you ever need to ship this back, or you upgrade to a new printer and you sell this one, or whatever happens, if this thing ever has to get shipped again, you're gonna wanna fix that back in place. One last thing, there is another notice here, points to note. The red liquid in the printhead and waste ink unit is the printhead protection liquid and will not affect the use. Again, just reminding us that, hey, everything's all good. You may see some red liquid here. That's totally fine. We're gonna clip that. There we go. Now our printhead assembly should move freely, and there we go. Okay, now we're gonna start our machine self-test, and to do this, we're gonna go ahead and plug in our machine and power it on here in the back. Now, once you've powered it on in the back, let's go ahead and press this first button right here. And that's gonna start our machine self-test. You'll notice the blue light is currently flashing while the machine performs its self-test. You'll know it's done when that blue light right here turns from flashing to a solid and steady color. All right, so now we have a steady blue color right here, which means the self-test is complete. Let's go ahead and do a performance test by pushing this third button over here. And this may take just a little bit longer, but that's okay. We're gonna let our machine do its thing. And again, we'll know it's complete once this button right here stops flashing. All right, now that we're back to solid blue over here, we know that our performance test is complete. We can go ahead and lower the lid. Now, if at any point in time you do notice that the two buttons right here are flashing red, do us a favor and go ahead and contact tech support right away. Shouldn't be the case, but just in case, at least you know what to do. Now, what's cool about the Procolored A4 is that the exit plate does have a built-in film slicer on there, which is really cool. So let's go ahead and unwrap this now. Now this plate actually comes fully assembled. We're just gonna go ahead and take the tape off of the slicer right here to free it up. You can actually do this as your very last step, but I'm gonna do it now. As you can see, now it unlocks it and frees it up to cut our film. Okay, so these two screws here are gonna get inserted right here, but then when we clamp it down, they're gonna kind of lock in right here. So we don't have to remove them. We're actually gonna just loosen them a little bit to give our bracket, or to give our exit plate, a little space to slide on. There we go. As you can see, we're just gonna kind of load it in, drop it in place, it should snap in, and you should notice that this exit plate is flush with the heating plate as the film exits your printer. And then this nifty thing, we're gonna see this in action in a minute, this is going to slice off all of our film, which is super easy and such a great touch. Now for this next step, you can go ahead and leave your printer plugged in and powered on. However, so I can show you guys, I'm gonna have to turn my printer around, so I will be unplugging mine. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and mount our roll holder brackets onto the printer. The screws are already on the printer, so we're just gonna go remove these really quick. What I find helpful is I'll put a screw already into one of the threads, and that way it's all right here. Now, of course, you're not gonna wanna tighten that all the way, just enough to get it locked in place, but then it's held up. So now you can just bring in your other screw. Tighten that up. Of course, you want to make sure it's nice and straight before you do your final tightening. No need to over tighten here, just firm enough to where your bracket is locked in place. Let's go ahead and repeat that on this other one. All right, and again, I'm going to go ahead and start this already through the hole, so it's much easier to get that started. We're not going to tighten all the way. Gonna load up our second screw. Get that one in there. And then now, right before our final tighten, we're just gonna make sure that's nice and straight. You wanna make sure it's firm, but no need to over-tighten here. There we go. Let's load our roll of DTF film. You wanna make sure you have the print side on top. So how do you know what side's the print side? An easy way to do that is to just give it a little tiny scratch. We're gonna lift this edge up here. And if you can scratch away, this might be hard to see on camera, but if you can scratch away a little portion of the coating, that's the print side. If we were to flip this around, we have a slightly glossier side. And when we scratch here, we don't really see anything being scratched away. So we're looking for the softer, more matte side that has a coating that could be scratched away. We want this side feeding from the top over the roll and into our machine. So now we're gonna go ahead and attach one end cap into the roll as tight and as snug as it's gonna go. You're gonna get your rod and put that in there. Now, if it doesn't go in, all that means is you need to loosen this adjustment screw. So I'm gonna go ahead and loosen that up until our rod slides in easy and smooth. There we go. Now on the other side, we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna go ahead and put that in there. And again, we're gonna loosen that up. To allow for our rod to go in nice and smooth. Sorry, I probably should have loosened that a little bit more. There we go. And we're gonna kind of push that in there, make sure the end cap is nice and snug onto the roll. Now we're gonna try to center it onto the roll. I'm gonna place it into the bracket. Now that it's on our bracket, it should roll nice and smooth. There shouldn't be a lot of give. However, we're gonna wait a few moments to tighten this and lock our roll in place. Next, we're gonna spin the printer around. We're gonna load our film into our printer, and then once it's nice and centered, then we're gonna lock our film in place. Okay, so now that I know that it's loading straight the way I want it to, I'm gonna go ahead and move that right there. And we're gonna go ahead and carefully feed it in. Now, in general, you do want your film to be centered with the path here. And I can see that mine is just a little bit more to my left, your right. So I'm gonna slide my film roll over just a little bit to where it's nice and centered. We're gonna feed it in manually until it stops and hits the rollers. I'm gonna go ahead and lift the lid. And I'm gonna feed it through. Now, as we feed it through, you kinda wanna help the roll, just to make sure it doesn't get caught on the lip of our tray. You're gonna want it to feed it just a little bit up so it goes through properly. There we go. And you're gonna feed it through just a little bit just to make sure it's feeding straight. And as you can see, first try, this is loading very straight. So I'm gonna roll it back here. Typically, you don't wanna let it feed too far back in, because then it can kinda get off the track or off the plate, the exit plate. So what I like to do is feed it back right about there. So you will lose just a teeny tiny bit of film at the front, but that's okay, because you're gonna need a place to grab it from anyways. Don't worry, totally fine. This is probably about where you wanna leave it. Now that our film's properly loaded, we're gonna go ahead and close this lid back up again. We're gonna go ahead and lock it into place on our roller bar. For that, I'm just gonna find that right here. Tighten that screw. Find the other one, there we go. Gonna roll it back. I just like to have that nice and tight. And we are now ready for our software installation. All right, so I have my dongles plugged in. Now, before we proceed, we're gonna have to create a safe folder. So we're gonna go to our C drive, and we're gonna create a new folder. And we're gonna go ahead and label it Procolored DTF. Okay, so now we have our Procolored DTF folder on C drive. And we have our files on our USB drive. Before we move these over, let's go ahead and create a protected folder. So we're gonna go to Windows Security. If it's not already popping up here, you could just type in Windows Security and it'll come up. And we're gonna go to Virus and Threat Protection. We're gonna manage our settings. And we're gonna scroll all the way down because we need to add an exclusion. And we're gonna add an exclusion. We're gonna select a folder, C drive. We're gonna go to Procolored DTF and we're gonna select that folder. There we go. Now we can close this. We're gonna get what's on our our manuals and files, USB drive. We're gonna get those and we're gonna drag them into that Procolored DTF folder. So the reason why we do this is so that way anything that you open up to install on your computer, you're not gonna have to trigger your antivirus every time because it's excluded, and because we know it's from a trusted safe source, we can go ahead and add it to this exclusions list, and now we're gonna have a breeze installing everything into our computer. Okay, now that we've moved all of our files over to our computer into this safe folder, we can go ahead and eject this USB drive here. Now, even though we were able to remove the manuals and software USB drive, anytime you're gonna use the ProRip software, you do wanna make sure that you keep that dongle connected to your computer at all times. So our next step is to go ahead and install the ProRip software. So we're gonna go to Software Driver. which is the second folder, and we're gonna click on this file right here, double click, and that's gonna start our install wizard. Yes. We're gonna click next, install. Gonna let that do its thing. Now, anytime this comes up, you're gonna go ahead and click repair. And once it's done, you can click close. Gonna agree to that and install. And we're gonna close. There we go, installed successfully, awesome. And now we're gonna click finish. I do like to leave that checked in, that way it just goes straight to running the program. All right, now this is the ProRip program. I'm really excited to have this open. We're gonna come back to this. Let's go ahead and proceed with the rest of our installation and setup. Now before we proceed, let's go ahead and make sure that our printer is plugged in, powered on, and we're actually gonna connect the USB cable from the printer to our computer. Once that's done, we're gonna go to the A4 drive. And depending on your operating system, most of us are operating on a 64-bit system, which is what I'm gonna select here. And you're gonna see the Epson AL800 driver. We're gonna click on the application right here. I'm gonna double click on that to install. And even though this is not an Epson printer, it does use the Epson printhead, which is why we're seeing that here. I'm gonna click OK. English is fine. We're going to accept these terms. Now it's important that your printer is not only plugged in and powered on in the back, but also that we have a steady blue light in the front. And the driver installation should be pretty automatic. Now it's time to establish our default settings for this printer. So we're gonna go right here. This is gonna be our canvas. And because we're working with an 8.5-inch wide film, we're gonna go ahead and set it to 8.5. Now you could set your length to whatever you want it to print. In this case, we're just gonna stick with a 12-inch height. There we go. And by clicking that magnifying glass, it's gonna fill the page with our dimensions. I'm gonna click these two arrows in the top right corner here. Now under device settings, we're gonna select printer. Now even though this is not the Epson AL800, it's the AL800 series because that's the print head that it uses. So we're gonna select that and we're gonna click OK. Next, we're gonna go to print management. Of course, we're gonna make sure that this is our A4 DTF. We're gonna set this as our default. And we're gonna close. Okay, so now at this point, you can either right click into this area and open printer preferences, or you can also click this printer right here, which is also gonna open up your printer preferences. We're gonna go to maintenance. And we're gonna go to Epson Status Monitor 3 and go ahead and accept do not display this message again. And we are looking for a ready sign. That lets us know that we are ready to proceed. Everything's been installed correctly. The print drivers are reading properly and we are ready to proceed. So we're gonna click OK. I'm going to click OK. All right, let's grab our bottles of ink and start with our ink installation. All right, now once you get all your bottles, you're gonna wanna give them a good shake. And I'm gonna try to see if I can get these all done at once. There we go. Let's shake them. Okay, that should do it. All right, so now let's go ahead and plug this second hole right here. You actually just wanna be kind of gentle with it. If you force it too fast, you might find you have a hard time plugging it up. And we're doing that so we don't lose the cap, because now we're gonna pull it out again gently. We're gonna pull it out of there. Just move it out of the way. Let's go ahead and get our funnel. You just kinda let that rest in there. And now it's time to fill it with the ink. Now you'll notice that all these rubber caps are color-coded. So now we're gonna go ahead and open up our ink. You're gonna wanna go slow. This is a water-based ink. So it's gonna flow nice and smooth. And we're gonna keep an eye on our fill line here, making sure that we're only filling it up to the top line. There we go. You will have some extra ink, so go ahead and just put your cap back on. And we're moving on to the next color. Now, one thing that's important is you don't want to be mixing inks. So I have a paper towel here with me. I'm going to go ahead and carefully pull this out, place it on the paper towel, and we're going to use a separate funnel for each individual color. Okay, so now your white tank is located back here, so let's go ahead and remove the cap. Go ahead and drop our funnel in. From the looks of it, I'm probably going to end up dumping this whole bottle. Yeah, that should be fine. We're going to go ahead and cap this here. What you want to do is you want to tighten it all the way. And then once it's tightened, loosen it just a bit so it could vent out. Now for this next step, you're going to want your syringe and the 5 pointy tips. Now I suppose if you wanted to be really stingy, you could just wash off each tip after every ink fill, but don't do that. They give you 5 for a reason. So we're going to start off. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to pull that nice and snug, very firmly onto the tip. And what we're going to do is we're going to pull out each of these individual ink dampers, and we're going to pull them out, and we're going to insert our syringe in to pull ink all the way through from the ink tanks, through the tubes, and to our print head. Now for this next step, you're probably going to want to have an extra cup on hand just to dispose of the excess ink that might fill your syringe as you're pulling the ink through. So I got that on hand right there. We're going to start with yellow. You want to be very careful. These dampers are very delicate. Now you should have received some extra units, some extra dampers with your unit, but no need to damage that if it's not necessary. You also don't want to really touch this delicate plastic outside. So the best way to handle the damper is by the firm plastic on the edges, and you want the damper facing up like so. I'm going to hold it like this. Now when you're inserting the pointy tip of your syringe in, it's going to go in right here, and you should see it pierce through, and you should see just a tiny bit of the tip. You don't want to force it in too deep. See that in there, and you're just going to apply gently some suction, and you should see it does not take a lot of suction pressure to pull that in. We're going to keep drawing. We're going to keep applying gentle suction pressure until our damper is completely full. Now, as you can see, I'm getting a little bit of ink into my syringe. It's perfectly normal. It's perfectly okay. I'm going to pull it out. I'm going to dump that into my cup. But before I do, I want to carefully place this damper back where it belongs on my print head. And again, careful not to touch that delicate plastic shielding out there. There we go. You don't need to be too firm, but definitely give it like a nice firm press. And on to the next one. Okay, and now for our final step in loading the ink, we're going to gently pull this tube out of our waste collection unit, waste collection tank. Now you don't need a clean orange tip for this part. You can just insert it into the tube. Make sure it's nice and tight so we have a good seal. And we're going to do the same thing. We're just going to draw some ink in, applying gentle suction pressure. With the syringe, we're having a nice steady pull. You don't want to push any air back in there. There we go. It takes a little while. And we're just going to pull this through. Keep pulling. Probably going to need 2 hands for this. Until we get You don't need a full syringe here. But we're gonna hold it. The other thing you wanna make sure you don't do is you don't let the syringe pump air back in. Very important here. You're gonna pinch the tube as you pull it off of your needle. There we go. That's okay. Gonna remove that there. We're gonna go ahead and put it back into our tank before we unpinch the tube, and there we go. You're gonna put it back in there. And now our waste collection, all of our waste ink is gonna go back into this collection tank. Okay, now before we proceed, we're just gonna go ahead and recap all of these. We're gonna close the vents on them. And we're gonna tighten this up back here. There we go. Let's close our lid. And now we're gonna hold down the power button for a second to power on the printer. We'll know it's ready to go once that blinking blue light turns to a solid blue light. Okay, we got our solid blue light. Let's go back over to our ProRip software to complete our setup and do our first print. So we're just gonna right click anywhere down here, and that's gonna open up this little menu. We're gonna go to printer preferences. And since it's using an Epson print head, we're gonna use the Epson layout here. We're gonna go over to maintenance. Now, before I even do my first nozzle check, we're gonna go ahead and perform a head cleaning. So we're gonna click on this here. And typically we're gonna perform just a regular head cleaning. The power cleanings are usually reserved for when we really need to clear up some nozzle clogs. But for this initial setup, we should be fine with anywhere from 1 to 3 head cleanings. So we're just gonna do one for now, click start. And we're gonna let our printer do its thing. Now you will notice the blue light in the front is gonna start blinking. That's totally normal. And we're gonna know that the head cleaning is finished once that blue light goes back to a steady solid color. Okay, and then now that the head cleaning has completed on screen, we also get a notification. It's asking us to print a nozzle check pattern, which is exactly what we do wanna do. Now you could click here. The other thing that you can do is to go back. You can always just click nozzle check right here from this menu as well. And click print. Now this is kind of letting you know what you're looking for on the nozzle check. I'll say this, it is a little bit difficult to see the yellow ink on here, but you don't have to look very close for that. And what we want are some clean nozzles or clean patterns printed. If we see breaks in any of the pattern like you see on screen here, then that's a sign that we're gonna need to repeat the head cleaning. Again, you should get a nice clean nozzle check pattern after about 2 or 3 head cleanings. If you have to go past 4 or 5, do us a favor and just call technical support just to make sure everything's set up properly. So now to inspect your pattern, we're gonna come to the front. We're gonna push this down button a little bit, spit that right out. And as I can see here, I actually have a great pattern. And again, it's very hard to see the yellow pattern on there, but this pattern looks absolutely fine. Okay, so our nozzle check is done. I'm just gonna click finish and okay to close that out. Let's go ahead and get into our first print. So we're gonna click these arrows over here to get back into our workspace. Gonna click the import icon right here. And we're gonna print none other than our favorite superhero, Mr. CMYK Man. I love CMYK Man. So he's importing, we're gonna click on him, of course. You go down here and you could resize him. And we're gonna max this out. 7.5 inches wide, which is great, because he's about almost 11 inches tall. He's a very tall superhero. Now to print is very easy. We're just gonna go ahead and click rip up here. Now for your resolution, you could print in 1440 by 1440 or 1440 by 720. I'm gonna go with 1440 by 720. I think that looks great. Now you could up that, you could go to 1440 by 1440, but just keep in mind that is gonna significantly slow down your printer. But that's up to you. For me, this is gonna be fine. I'm gonna go ahead and click print, and let's see how this comes out. All right, our print is done. We're gonna go ahead and feed it out just past this nifty little film slicer. I like to give myself a little bit of extra room. And with one hand, you're gonna hold it down, slice it off. So clean, so easy, and look at that, so nice. For more information on all Procolored printers and DTF supplies, head on over to heatpressnation.com.